So it's been a while since we last met Alice, who was working on Vertex cover. And actually, last time we left off, Alice wasn't happy like that, actually. Alice was quite unhappy because we proved Vertex cover to be NP complete. So last time we left off, there was little hope for her to ever solve her Vertex cover problem that she's working on. Now, I promised to show you an intelligent algorithm for Vertex cover, or at least one that's more intelligent than brute force. But in order to do that, let's first start out with the brute force algorithm. So let's say Alice is running her algorithm on a very simple graph like this, just 4 vertices and 5 edges. What her simple algorithm or brute force algorithm was doing, it was considering all possible assignments of 0 and 1 to the vertices. So for 4 vertices, we had a total of 16 possibilities that her algorithm needed to look at. So her algorithm starts out, for example, by saying, oh, let's put no vertices into the vertex cover. And of course, this leaves all edges uncovered. So it's not even a valid solution. Then it would maybe start out by saying, oh, let's put one vertex into the vertex cover. There's actually 4 different ways of doing this. And at least this time we have some edges covered, but still none of these solutions is a valid solution because we still have uncovered edges, and I've drawn them red here so you can better see them. So no valid solution for any of those. The algorithm continues and says, oh, then let's put 2 vertices into the vertex cover. And finally, the algorithm has found a valid vertex cover for our small network, but of course it has also found many, many vertex covers that are actually invalid because not all edges are covered. So again, redundant, redundant, redundant. And now the algorithm proceeds, and although it has already found a solution where 2 vertices are enough for the vertex cover, it now puts 3 vertices into the vertex cover, which has the advantage that it will always find a valid vertex cover, but the disadvantage that it's totally redundant and unnecessary work. Same thing if you put all 4 into the vertex cover. Valid solutions, but not the best possible ones. So this is what her brute force algorithm is doing. And you can see why brute force is so stupid, because first of all, it considers many solutions where you could have immediately said, look, this is not valid. You've taken an edge and none of the 2 endpoints is in the vertex cover. So why even consider all the other possibilities? As soon as you have an edge that is not covered, you can basically scrap that solution and go looking for another one. And the other thing that her algorithm did that wasn't very smart was once it had found a solution with 2 vertices, it still tried all the solutions with 3 vertices and 4 vertices. It could have stopped right here because it knew that it would not be able to find any vertex cover that is smaller. And that is the difference between brute force and intelligent force. So in brute force, we go through all of the possible assignments of the vertices into the vertex cover, out of the vertex cover. Whereas what we're now going to do is we're going to avoid stupid choices. And that is the basis for intelligent force.